Abu Dharr radiallahu anhu, he said that Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, he came out to his companions one day and he said to him, shall I not inform you of the most beloved word to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala? Meaning what he's about to say sallallahu alayhi wa sallam is a word in which earns a person the love of Allah azza wa jal. And it increases his love of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala as well. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala himself is about to reveal the most beloved word he loves to hear from the servant. Yani, rest assured that this word, as much as you say it, Allah azza wa jal loves it and he accepts it. And your love for Allah would absolutely increase. Allah azza wa jal's love for you is going to be guaranteed. For Nabi sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, he said to them, this is one hadith in Sahih Muslim, he said to them, inna ahabba al-kalami ila Allah, the most beloved word to Allah, subhanallah wa bihamdih. In other narrations, it mentions subhanallah, alhamdulillah, wa la ilaha illallah, allahu akbar. But this narration here, it focuses on subhanallah wa bihamdih. In other words, generally, the dhikr, the words that Allah loves, are subhanallah, alhamdulillah, wa la ilaha illallah, wallahu akbar. But more specifically, it's subhanallah wa bihamdih because of this hadith. Abu Dharr radiallahu anhu, he also says that Nabi sallallahu alayhi wa sallam was asked, ayyul kalami afdal, what word is better for a person to say? Better, do you know what better means? This is going to be better than anything you will say. And the goodness in your life is going to come from behind this word. For Nabi sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, he said to them, it is the word that Allah chose for his angels. And he chose for his servants, subhanallah wa bihamdih. Allah Azza wa Jal chose for this word to be the dhikr of the angels from the day he created them until the day they all die. Subhanallah. And Nabi sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, he said, shuf al hadith, he's huge hadith. Whoever finds the night very difficult to get up and worship Allah in, and he withheld his money, he's not able to take out money and give fi sabilillah consistently. He was afraid and terrified from this reality. Maybe he becomes poor. Tayyib, two things now. And he was afraid from the enemy. فالنبي sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, he advised such a person, then make sure you say in abundance, subhanallah wa bihamdih, and that is going to be much better for him than if he was to give in weight gold and silver the size of a mountain. Nabi sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, in an authentic hadith, he says, isn't any one of you able to do the deeds that are equal to the mountain of Uhud? For Sahaba radiallahu anhum, they said, who can do deeds that are equal to the size of Jabal Uhud? For Nabi sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, he said, kullukum yastati'u. Each and every single one of you is able to do so. What is that? Nabi sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, he said to them, subhanallah a'zamu min Uhud. That the word subhanallah itself in reward, it is much more intense and it is much more in weight in its reward than the mountain of Uhud itself. Why, my brothers in Islam? Because the word subhanallah itself, it's supposed to solidify iman in a person's heart. And it is supposed to bring al-yaqeen, certainty, in a person's heart, so much so that certainty becomes as strong as a mountain in the person's heart. Therefore, subhanallah was more in reward than the mountain of Uhud. And this is effect. Shuf Jabal Uhud, from the day Allah created it until now, it hasn't moved. Subhanallah is much better than it. The strongest wind will not move the mountain, right? Yani, in other words, the strongest fitan that will come on you, they will not shake a person's iman in Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala.